Welcome to the second season of Under Review, presented by Continental Office. I'm Jody Shelley, and I'm going to sit down with some of these players. We're going to get video, and we're going to get into their minds and see why they did things, some of the plays they made out there, how it happened, get it from their thoughts on the plays. So let's get after it. Let's get Under Review with some of the Columbus Blue Jackets. All right, today I'm here with Zach Werenski. Zach, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Our pleasure. And you are under review. All right, this is behind the net. There's Mudavara. So this is you anticipating. You know this guy's backed out. Tell us what you see here when you, just before you get it.
Yeah, Nudy pulls up and Kane's not looking at me. And then once he kind of realizes I'm coming, he's going the other way. So I kind of just have to protect it for a second. And I have enough speed to go around him. And then Crawford can't really see it because the guy tries to block it. I tried going like low blocker, I mean, and it ends up on the ice. I kind of fan on it, but.
Great shot.
Yeah, I'll take it.
Absolutely, good play. All right, this is a face-off play. There's no lane here.
Yeah, no lane, but I know our guys are going to the net. Something we talk about is at least getting one guy to the net. Here, there's three big guys on our team, and you can kind of tell they're all trying to get there. So I just try throwing one kind of for a bounce off the bend wall. You know, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. In this case, it did, but a quick whistle by the ref.
But what a smart play. So when you don't have that lane, do you, this is at home, so you know the bounce of the boards?
A little bit. I've kind of practiced it a little bit more this year than I have in the past. I think guys kind of get in lanes now more than ever. Especially with me and Jonesy being two offensive defensemen. So I think that's a really useful play we can start using a little bit more.
All right, what are you seeing here and you're anticipating? You end up going on quite a route.
Yeah, Jonesy comes in, just misses. Puck comes to me and the forward kind of comes with me, but I think if I go, it opens up Brad to either walk or shoot. So I try creating some motion and then the forward's not going to go that far down. So I just try jumping by him, getting the rebound. Just slides by Cam there, I try hitting him. And then I'm just kind of moving and Jonesy's cutting through and I'm going through, Brad's open. So I just tried, you know, creating chaos and Jonesy was through, like Jonesy's back door.
Yeah, so that's PL's, that's pretty awesome.
Yeah, PL's wide, Brad's coming through the slot, Cam's fighting there. And then goalie gives me a little room, but I just put it a little wide and then everyone's on the back check.
So you go through there hoping that player goes with you. So a forward, for those who don't know, forwards usually stop and hand off the defenseman if he's going in the offensive zone at about the top of the circle. So you know this guy's not going to go with you all the way down to the goal line. So right here, your offense, you're gone. You're going to leave that guy in the dust and see what happens.
Yeah, if a puck pops out to me there, I either have a shot. In this case, it goes to the corner. I'm the first one on it because the D's worried about Dubois and Cam. And then it's kind of, if you watch, I'm climbing up. Jonesy's going through. Brad's wide open. They don't know who to cover. Then here the guy comes, two guys are on bread, and then leaves me open.
And there you are again at the blue line.
Yeah, leaves me open. Goalie leaves me some room, just missed my shot, but Jonesy's back door, I probably could have hit him. And then the best part is we have our forwards back playing D. And as a defenseman, that gives you a lot of confidence to go when you know your forwards are going to be back
right,
supporting you. So something me and Jonesy do quite often and I think pretty well.
This is quite a play in the neutral zone. Just a subtle play, but very effective. It's a one-time backhand pass through the middle.
Yeah, we talk about playing fast and playing north and getting the puck up to our forwards, and it's just one of those where it's bouncing, so I tried to time it at the right moment to get it up to Cam. He's kind of creeping behind everybody there, ends up on his tape, and I thought we get it up to the forwards because they make plays like this, and their D's kind of falling around, and then Cam makes a great play and with Nasher and end up scoring a big goal there.
So you don't back off very much. You do a good job of standing up. It's just the confidence in your ability. You're skating, you're making those plays.
Yeah, I think you just have to trust yourself and trust your skating. You know, when we're standing up and we're playing aggressive and our forwards are reloading, it's really hard for other teams to create much. And, you know, we talk about shrinking the neutral zone and just playing fast and having the D up the ice. And when we do that, we're a hell of a hockey team. And
well, that was a heck of a play.
Yeah, that was an awesome play. I was watching
by them. You?
No, by them too.
But, I mean, the rolling puck, I mean, I could try that 10 times and I know where it would go. It would go over my stick. And you have pressure and you've got to time it right and it's right on the tape.
Yeah, on the tape, I guess, was just a bonus, but I just
you just to, wanted to go in that way.
I just tried to get up there as quick as I could.
Good play.
And out to the neutral zone it comes once again. The Jackets chipping ahead. And here's Atkinson with it in front, and he scores!
Well, Zach, we appreciate you taking your time.
Of course.
You're through the under review, and that does it for us.